Beech. Due to the grain and colour, I'd say it came from the beechwood forest near the valley. And when I take a good look at the way the carving was done, it has all the marks of a left-handed carpenter, someone between 38 and 39 years old. The servants at the Abbey have been entrusted with keeping the stone floor clean. It doesn't seem to be very valuable. What I mean to say is artistic value. I think it's understandable that this is not the right moment to talk with him. The gravestone of the donors who financed construction of the chapel. Requiescat in pacem. Saint Torquato, a bishop and martyr from the first century. This church is dedicated to him. He was a famous missionary. May he rest in peace. Here is where one enters the chapter hall. It's locked. No one will be inside. The children born in the course of a year are baptized here. The baptism font. There's no water in it at the moment. It's only filled to celebrate the Paschal Vigil. Here lie the mortal remains of the Duke of Sicard, who financed the construction for nearly all of the church. The Duke of Sicard has already done enough for this church. May he rest in peace. The gravestone of Abbot Emilio de Pisa, who passed away in 1132. He was the one who had this church built. May he rest in peace. A wooden image of Cristo de los Faldones, highly revered in this region. There'll be time to pray to him. The gravestone of Abbot Valero, who consecrated the church in 1185. He was Abbot Emilio de Pisa's successor. Requiescat in pacem. This is the way down to the crypt. It's been locked with a key. It doesn't seem to be any common candle. It's very soft.
Master, what are you doing? Did you steal a liturgical object from a church altar?
Silence. Not a word. If you open your mouth one more time, I'll send you off to Egidio to muck out the stables. Bruno holds him in high esteem, and I think the feeling is mutual. I don't want to disturb him. He scared himself enough last night. Seems to be robust enough. I hope his energy is replenished during our stay at the Abbey. It's going to be needed for the journey back. Not necessary. I can get anywhere I want to at the Abbey on foot. He's currently keeping an eye on my old travelling companion. Bravo.
Yes?
I'd like to ask you a few questions about the mystery surrounding Anselmo's death.
Mystery? There's no mystery. A frankincense censer weighing 200 pounds fell on his head. If I'm not mistaken, accidents like that are fatal.
Didn't you ask yourself if maybe it wasn't an accident?
I don't ask. I thought questions were what you do.
Right you are, but you're forgetting that you must answer them.
No.
What do you mean, no?
I didn't ask myself if it wasn't an accident. Satisfied?
You seem to be quite sure of yourself.
Indeed, I'm sure.
A certainty in your reply. What is it based on?
My what? Brother, there are other monks at this abbey who speak Latin much better than I do. Please remember that I'm a simple grave digger. I mean, gatekeeper, the groom. Oh, I don't know myself anymore.
What I want to say is, why do you believe that Anselmo's death was an accident?
I was there.
Beg your pardon?
I was one of those holding the rope for the censer, together with Nicholas and Gottfried. We had just fixed the rope in place and were wondering if the height was right when it suddenly split apart. Anselmo and the abbot were underneath the censer, but Anselmo didn't get away in time. As you can plainly see, if there's anyone to blame for all this, then it's a rotten rope.
Where is the murder weapon? What I want to say is about the accident.
Back there. It was taken here since there was no room for the repairs in the smithy.
I'd like to ask you a few questions about the mystery surrounding Anselmo's death.
Mystery? There's no mystery. A frankincense censer weighing 200 pounds fell on his head. If I'm not mistaken, accidents like that are fatal.
Do you think it could be the devil's work?
The devil? Do you mean evil incarnate? Satan?
That's right. In all his many names.
I beg you, brother. The cause of Anselmo's death is that he was in the wrong place at the wrong time. That's all. The devil incarnate. What poor wretch came up with such a foolish idea like that?
The abbot is concerned that there's more behind the gatekeeper's death than merely the irony of fate we keep hearing so often.
He'll have his reasons. The abbot is an intelligent person, even though he does confuse the smell of snuff with the smell of sulfur.
You seem to be quite sure of yourself.
Indeed, I'm sure.
Do you know what they were talking about?
Nicholas and Gottfried?
No, Anselmo and the abbot.
No, I couldn't hear them. And anyway, it was none of my business. All I did was my work.
Do you think someone could have had a reason to murder Anselmo?
For what reason? For coming too late to Mass or sneezing during compliant prayers? For heaven's sake, we're an abbey, not a seaman's tavern. Differences aren't settled with knives.
One thing is clear. If it wasn't an accident, then there must be a reason. I have to find out that reason, and that's why I have to ask questions.
In that case, you've picked out the wrong monk. I don't poke around in others' lives, and they don't poke around in mine.
Was anyone else in the church besides Anselmo, the abbot, and the ones who wanted to hang the censer?
No, just us. And besides, the church has very good acoustics. If anyone else has been there, we'd have heard. I don't know, at least footsteps.
That's strange.
What?
You said you wouldn't have been able to hear the conversation between Anselmo and the abbot, even though they were only a few meters away. Yet you're certain that no one else was in the church because you would have heard them due to the acoustics.
That's not what I said.
Excuse me, but those were your words.
Yes. All right, no. That's not what I wanted to say. I neither heard anyone nor saw anyone.
That's a different story.
I want to set one thing straight. I did not see anyone. All I am is a simple gravedigger. I mean, gatekeeper or stable groom. What do I know?
About something different. I see you're keeping an eye on our mounts.
The abbot's orders. I have to clean and groom your horse every day during your stay here. It seems that you're a very illustrious guest and must be treated accordingly. That means if there's anything I can do for you...
Much obliged, but I managed to wash all by myself this morning. You're a very busy monk.
What other choice do I have?
We all have our work cut out for us.
Right you are. One job, not several. I came here as a gravedigger. Since Anselmo's death, I'm now the new gatekeeper. And now, thanks to you, the groom.
Don't worry. We won't be staying here long.
I hope not. I can't stand the smell in the stables.
Believe me, brother. There are things at this abbey that give off a worse smell. We're leaving. Are you going to be nearby?
I hope not.
There you go. The involuntary cause of the whole matter. Let's take a closer look at it. Interesting.
What have you found, Master? Oh my God, it's blood. You found some evidence.
Think about it, Bruno. Do you really believe that finding blood in a censer that struck a monk and killed him can automatically be called evidence? Besides, it's not blood at all.
It's not.
Look closely at the way it dried. If it were blood, the texture and color would look very different. I think it came from some kind of pigment. Red ink, for example. Isn't that interesting?
Ink? Why should ink be interesting?
Think about it, Bruno. Where can we find red ink at the Abbey? I don't see anything special. They're blank sheets. There's certainly enough paper in this library.